प्रोग्रामिंग इन सी प्लस प्लस यूनिट टू फंक्शंस इन सी प्लस प्लस एंड वर्किंग विथ ऑब्जेक्ट्स टॉपिक नेम एरे ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट ऑब्जेक्ट एज आर्ग्यूमेंट फ्रेंड फंक्शन इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट हाउ टू डिफाइन द मेंबर फंक्शंस how to create the array of the object and how to pass the object as argument and about the friend function. Objectives of this videos are defining member function, arrays within a class, static data member and static member functions, array of objects, passing object as an argument and return the object, friend function. Defining member functions. First of all, member functions is what? So whatever functions we are going to define inside the class, that they are called the member functions of that class. We can define that functions with at two places. First, outside the class, and second, inside the class definition. Outside the class definition, how to define it outside the class? The syntax to define the member function is return type, the class name, for which this function is going to define, scope resolution operator, function name, in bracket, the argument declaration, and inside this opening and closing bracket, function body. This type of declaration you have to do outside the class. For example, if we have created one class student, then how to create the getData function outside the class, then void student after the completion of definition for the class student, write void student scope resolution operator getData function opening and closing bracket and write down the coding inside that opening and closing bracket. Inside the class definition, so here there is a class student, opening and closing bracket. In between this opening and closing bracket, whatever functions we are going to define, that is called the member functions which are defined inside the class. So here this putData function, it is defined inside the class student. So that's why this putData is known as, or it is declared inside the class student. Array within a class. We can use the array as a private or public data member of the class. Here there is an example, class array. Array is a name of class. Inside that we define A with 5 data member and this is known as an array. In the public section of this class, first declare one function getData which is used to scan the 5 members of array A using this for loop. Void putData, it is used to display the 5 members of array A. Now inside the void main, create a object of class array, array A1. Here A1 is the object of the class array. A1.getData, it is going to call this getData function and scan the 5 values from the user. And that 5 values are stored as a inside the A of 5 for object A1. Now next A1.putData. This A1.putData function is going to call this putData function and whatever data is scanned using this getData function, that is going to display for the array A. Static data member. A data member of the class that can be qualified as a static with which characteristics then the first characteristic is it is initialized to 0 when the first object of its class is created. No other initialization is permitted and only the one copy of the data member is created for the entire class and it is shared by all the object of that class. So static data member is a data member of that particular class, which is the copy of that member is created only once. The number of object, if the number of object are multiple, then also the copy of the data static data member is only once. How to create the static data member? Data type, then the name of class, scope resolution operator, variable name is equal to value. This value is not a compulsory part of the static data member. For example, there is a one class item. In that, I want to create a static data member count. Then how to declare int? Int is a data type of count, item, the name of class, scope resolution operator, and the name of variable. Now see here, class item, in that static integer count is declared. Okay. Outside the class, int, item, scope resolution operator, count is declared. Now for the item, three objects are created, i1, i2 and i3. So code is created for this all three object i1, i2 and i3. Why? Because code is not a static data member. But count, the copy of count is created only once. It is common for all the objects. See here, copy of count is created only once whether there are three objects are created. Okay, here three different objects are created, but count is created only once. That means the static data member is common to all the objects. Static member functions. The member functions of the class which is declared with the static keyword are known as a static member functions. Which are the characteristics of this member function? It can have access only to the other static members declared inside the same class. And static member functions can be called using the class name as follow: class name, scope resolution operator, function name. Now see here, in the class test, there is a one static data member count. And here static void show count, this show count, it is a static member function. Okay, static member function, it is used to create or it is used to display the value of variable count. Okay, the count, the value of count is going to display using this show count function, and it is a static function. This static function is able to take only the static members of that particular class. Okay. So whenever we are going to display the show count, whenever we are going to call the show count function, at that time it is going to display the value of count. And count is called, the copy of count is only one. Array of the object. We can create the array of the object like class name, space array name, inside bracket size. So with the same class we can able to create the multiple object with the same name. For example, class book, get data and put data are the functions of class book. See here, inside the void main, here book 3, this is the array of the class books. Okay. Now for this array we have to call the get data function and put data function. So here we are going to use a for loop. Three objects are there with the single name, so take the for loop starts from 0 to 3, and 3 times this function is going to call get data. Same way, 3 times this put data function is going to call. Passing object as an argument. The object of the class can be passed as an argument to a member function as well as a non-member functions, either by the value or by the reference. When the object is passed by the value, a copy of the actual object is created inside the function. Here there is a one class complex. The create the object, three objects of the class complex C1, C2, C3. In C1 and C2 store some data, store some value for the complex number. So complex number contain the real and imaginary part. Okay. So in the C3 it is going to store the addition of C1 and C2. So create one function add complex number. In that complex COMP1 and COMP2, these both are the object. Okay. Here this C1 and C2 are the object. So the data of C1 is passed to COMP1 and the data of C2 it is passed to COMP2. Okay. And the real part of that COMP1 and the imaginary part of the COMP2 is stored in the real and image variable, and this real and image variable are for the C3 object. So here these both are passed as a object as argument. See here, C1 and C2 are passed as a object as argument. Friend function. To make an outside function friendly to access, we have to create a friend function using the friend keyword. Characteristics of friend function. It is not inside the class to which it has been declared as a friend. It is not in the scope of the class. It cannot be called using the object of that particular class. Friend function cannot be invoked like a normal functions without the help of the object. It cannot be accessed the member names directly. It can be declared either in a public or the private part of the class, and it may have the object as argument. Now see here, there is a one class XYZ and another class ABC. Inside XYZ class there is a one object A, and inside ABC class there is a one object B. Now I want to compare the value of A and B using some other function max. So I have to create this max function as a friend function. So I can able to access this max function from this both the class. Inside the class, just you have to declare the function. Definition of function you have to write outside the class. Like this, void max, create the object of first class, create the object of second class. Okay. Now, from ABC class, how to access the value of B, so P dot B. And from XYZ class, how to access the value of A, then Q is the object of XYZ, Q dot A, it gives the value of A. Compare the value of A and B through the object of class ABC and XYZ. And if this comparison is true, if B is greater than A, then B is max, else A is max. Okay. From the void main, how to create this max function? So this max function is created without any object. So max, and inside this bracket the object of two class, the object of first class ABC and the object of another class, that is XYZ. Here inside the max function we are going to pass the object as argument. Okay. So max is a common functions for the class XYZ and the ABC. Once again, this friend function we have to declare inside the class, and we have to define the friend function outside the class. And to declare the friend function, we must have to use a keyword friend before the name of function. Thank you.